Blackbeard seized the Queen Anne's Revenge because it was the perfect ship for a pirate. Now, archaeologists are building a picture of the six-month period in which she sailed under his command.
Having that big ship out there, it would give him a pretty good psychological advantage over his opponents.
This ship terrorized the Caribbean and the coasts of North and Central America. It captured English, Spanish, and French vessels. So how did it end up on the seabed off the coast of North Carolina?
Amongst merchantmen, which were his normal prey, he was certainly outgunned any merchantman that was in the waters at that time.
The team believes Blackbeard made extensive modifications to the ship. Could this be the key to what happened?
Pirates typically were beefing up the armament on the vessels they captured, and they would have skilled carpenters among them to help, you know, add more gun ports. In the case of Queen Anne's Revenge, Blackbeard was definitely adding weapons as he went along.
When Blackbeard captured Concord, she was carrying 14 guns on that last voyage, compared to the 28 that she could have been carrying.
Though he preferred to intimidate, the signs say Blackbeard was fully prepared to fight.
We have tentatively identified 32 guns on the ship. A lot of them we just discovered this year. We've been working on this thing for 15 years, and so amazingly, we're finding more guns every year we go out. According to some sources, she had 40 guns on board. I think we have not found the last gun.
For 300 years, Blackbeard's cannon have been hidden from view. The guns recovered so far range from anti-personnel weapons to cannon which could shatter another ship's hull. The largest could fire a 6-pound ball over a mile, making the Queen Anne's Revenge very hard to outrun. Any vessel within close range risked obliteration.